Okay, thank you attending. My name is Yosuke Yamashiki. I put the Alexandre because I was grown up in Brazil and I was studied in the University of Sao Paulo too. But actually I'm Japanese. I want to become a Brazilian, but only the name. Okay, so let me just introduce what I will talk because the last presentation was excellent, and I was thinking to skip this because they introduced everything that I wanted to talk. But I like to repeat them because all of the disaster, the different type of the disaster are very, very important and very, very typical, and it is difficult to discuss in integration manner. So our session mainly address the future disaster. So if you think the future disaster, you have to increase the resilience. And to do that, you have to prepare, you have to make preparedness and reduce the vulnerability. And to do that, you have to make a prediction and alert. However, how we can cope with the low probability and high impact disaster to be discussed in our future session. And a different session I will talk in the later, I'm sorry. But this is the main fundamental question, because you know that the human is suffered, and we have to think about the real existence issues. And I would like to focus, first of all, about the space disaster and the historical disaster, and then the Earth disaster, and trying to make the comparative sketch for each occurrence. So if you think about the space disaster, there is, I would say three, this asteroid comet attack and solar flare, and the final one is the gamma ray burst. This is just a very, very rare event, and no one really think about in a serious way, but there are one scientist who is actually thinking about this might be happening, but the type of the disaster, the solar flare and the GLB, is very, very similar. And the first one is very similar to the volcanic eruption. This is an illustration of the human history. And we have 4.5 billion years of our Earth history. But most of the Earth history was a repeating disaster. But after the Permian, after, for example, the Paleozoic period, we have between the Paleozoic and Mesozoic, we have a Permian disaster, which killed almost all living. And then we have the end of the Permian period and the Mesozoic and the Cenozoic period. There is a big disaster induced by the asteroid, which we call it a KT or KPG disaster. And these are space-based disaster. So this is commonly understood. It's a big five disaster. It's in the historical manner. We have a Cretaceous Paleogene, the KT extinction event. This is what I was talking. And also the Triassic Jurassic, TRJ extinction event, and Permian Triassic event. And also Late Devonian event, and Ordovician Silurian extinction event. And these are classified mainly asteroid attack and volcanic eruption and climate change. And these are the common understanding. However, there is no fundamental proof except the one, the KPG. KPG, the KT, this was the evidence proved by the scientists. There is an iridium in the KT boundary layer. But other disasters are not understood very correctly. So this is a KT or KPG asteroid impact. It was hypothesized by the hit by the asteroid with 15 kilometers of diameter and killing almost 70% of the species. There is another discussion that the massive volcanic eruption occurred in the end of the Permian period, killed 90% of the all living species. And that disaster induced several things, the global warming, and the end, there is the ocean, Great Ocean Anoxia event. However, this is also one scientist is saying that PTR or Permian disaster also might be asteroid attack. Of course, this is not the very accepted event. However, they find helium and argon, which is rare in the Earth, but it's rich in the asteroid, in the layer. So they are saying that all mass extinction event might be associated by the asteroid attack. Of course, there is no proof yet, but this was published in the 2002. And there is a very good understood that Ordovician Silurian mass extinction event was considered as climate change. The decrease of the ocean level stopped oceanic circulation, shut down the hydrological cycle, and then there is a climate change, and probably that is because the reason why happening the Ordovician Silurian event. However, there are interesting scientists that Bruce Lieberman in the University of Kansas, he is saying that the GLB, the gamma ray burst, might be the cause of killing the trilobite, which is very common at the period, which is their larvae was in the surface of the ocean. And that was very tricky paper. Of course, not everybody believes that, but this is very interesting because the disaster, the GLB is actually, this is the GLB, it's the big, the massive, the gamma ray burst. Gamma ray burst is an unbelievable event because the luminosity is more than all luminosity of all existing galaxies. Because the luminosity of the galaxy is 10 power 36. However, the luminosity of the gamma ray burst is 10 power 44 watt, which is 10 to 8th power compared to the galaxy of the luminosity. This is an extreme event. And it happened very rare. However, it can be observed 300 times per, or 30 times per year, and which means 1,000 times per year. But if it happened, of course, not only the civilization, they can cause the end of the Earth too. There is a wealth layer star in the 7,500 light years from the Earth, and they are concerned having a very big gamma ray burst. The gamma ray burst, even if it's happening 6,000 light years away, they might cause a mass extinction. If this happens 1,000 light years away, then a 100,000 megaton explosion. If it happens 100 light years, melt surface of the atmosphere and everything, and this is very, very shocking event. However, what I would like to emphasize is that the talk, the gamma ray burst, in some sense, it's similar to the solar super flare. And the solar flare will be discussed by Isobe, Professor Isobe, after my talk. This is asteroid impact, and this is illustration I got from Wikipedia of the Chicxulub event. And this is a Chicxulub crater with a diameter of 170 kilometers. It's a huge diameter. And probably that killed the old dinosaurs and 70% of the living things. But the important thing is, according to the report submitted by the Dr. Michel to the United States Congress, that they are proving every 10 years or we are happening, or every 10 to 15 years or 20, 30 years, there is a big impact equivalent to the Hiroshima bomb. So this is a location where the asteroid hit to the Earth, but we didn't recognize. But most of them are very small, but sometimes it's very big. And we have a guest from the JAXA, Dr. Yoshikawa, who might comment on that. And there is an issue that MN4 asteroid that might be coming to the Earth on 2029 and April 13, and they come much closer to the Earth than the communication satellite. And there is a discussion whether this Apophis, this is a human-killing asteroid, might be coming to the Earth. However, now the probability is assumed to be much lower than initially thought. However, that kind of issue is always happening because the most of the NEO, near Earth object, could not be found because there are almost 30% of the hundredth meter size of the NEO have been found, but less than 1% of the 130 meters NEO have been detected by NASA in 2013. So we have to increase the capacity to acceptance. I would like to introduce how big the disaster scale is. If you put the Hiroshima bomb as one, the Tunguska event, which is happened 100 years ago, was 1,000. And the nuclear winter is 5.3 to the fifth power. However, if you think about the Chicxulub event that killed all the dinosaurs, this is an event of the 5.5 to 10 power, 10 to the 10th power. So this is enormous scale, the impact the asteroid attack is. So these are the discussions that we like to make. But the interesting thing is I made a very rough comparative study. So if you say that DRV, that may happen every 1 billion years, so 10 to the 9th power. And the future threat, we don't know, because when no one know when this happened. Supervolcano, killing locally by lava and ash, globally by gas, and 10 to the 6th power, it's a big eruption like Toba, or 10 to 4th to 6th power. The last one is the Toba. It's 74,000 years ago. And next one might be the Yellowstone, but in Japan, the Aso and Kikai might be issued. Asteroid, the big one, was 65 million years ago. However, the locally, we have Tunguska, and also we have in the Russian, in the, I think, just 3 to 4 years ago, right? And superfire, and that will be discussed in the Isobes session. However, that will kill the modern civilization, and the last one is a bigger one, is 1859, but probably the bigger one might be happened in the past that he will discuss. And global warming is a different thing because it might be happening 10 to 5th power or 10 to 6th power in naturally. However, we are accelerating that frequency. And then we, and also the important thing is it's ongoing. The outbreak of infectious disease, it might be 10 to the 1st to 3rd power because every 10 years, every 100 years, big one is happening. And 2014, we have an Ebola outbreak in Africa. And probably Professor Mitsuyama will be discussing this more clearly. And we have terrorism issue. We didn't think about that, but it was happened last year in Paris, right? So these different type of the issue. And then we have earthquake. This will be 10 to the 1st power. Every 10 years, they are big one is happening. Actually, we in Japan, we have more happening. And probably we have to think about the next Kanto big earthquake and probably the Nankai. And it might be happening every time. Tsunami, the big one is 100 years or 1,000 years. However, we didn't think about occurrence of Tohoku, right? And flood, actually it's happening every year, right? Every year or every month. So because probably it's connected to the global warming and probably the climate change. And then finally I put the AI singularity that was discussed, it's a modern civilization. We don't know it's happened before, but it might be happening in 20 years. However, someone say it was already happening, the singularity, depending on how you count them, right? So if you list all the different types of the disaster and the frequency and the impact, you have to think about different direction, different discussion. This is just what we are doing. We are developing, this is Dr. Hosono who made a calculation scheme for the impact. And also I am, this is just introduction of the calculation. And I'm also doing the database of the exoplanet, and then we want to introduce the asteroid component. And I will skip this. And Earth disaster, and we have to think about Earth disaster flood and volcanic event, I will sleep. This is actually disaster happened in Brazil, and it killed almost 1,000 people. It was 2011, but the same year we have East Japan earthquake. And this is just the introduction of the Fukushima, the radioactive measurement that we have done with the publication of how what I involved. This is some report what I published, and if you are thinking, please come to the journal. But this is a disaster. It seems that it's happened the same region, but what the over two was happening in Brazil, and the last two was happening in Japan. This is Nagano, and this is Hiroshima. I am developing the prediction frame to predict the occurrence of the debris flow. This is a numerical tool, and this is the real occurrence of the debris flow place. And we would like to establish to increase the predictability of that kind of disaster. So this was all my concerning. But tomorrow we will discuss the preparedness for the present disaster, mainly focusing on the financial mechanism and discussing the present session and risk hedge derivative by inviting and chaired by Professor Kanamura, Professor Stefan Truek is okay, Truek. And he will talking how to enhance resilience and timing of the investment for the adaptation of the climate impacted hazard. And also Professor Ohashi will be discussing mainly CAT index future to be created. And also the past session, the past session, as I told you, that Professor Mitsuyama and Professor Ogata will be, Koyama-sensei. Koyama and Professor Mitsuyama will talk about the lesson from the past, right? And this is an introduction of the fall session and also the issue to be raised. Thank you very much.